name's Mark. I'm a senior producer at Tennis Australia and currently working on version 2 of the AO Tennis Game. So we've been working with Big Ant on making sure that the venues in the game, Rod Laver Arena, Melbourne Arena, Margaret Court Arena, all look exactly like they do in real life.
AO2 brings the full precinct of the Australian Open for the first time.
We've given Big Ant designs to all the internal rooms and press conference room, other press conferences rooms that they can use to build more authenticity into the game.
We've actually added the entire Melbourne Park, so you've got the show courts, you've got Garden Square, everything that is happening during an Australian Open tournament, you get within the game.
The access they give us, you know, around Melbourne Park, we get to come down onto the courts, we get to really scope out what Melbourne Park is around the Open. It helps to create that overall authentic atmosphere to the game.
They're always involved in making sure we've got the right uniforms, making sure we get approvals for all the players, coming down to the office, playing the game, giving us feedback. So it's been fantastic.
It's really important that people can play with the guys that are currently number one.
We've got Nadal again, Barty, but we've added Kochanov, there's Pliskova, Kerber.
So we've got a whole bunch of Australian players in the game as well. We've got Sanasi Kokkinakis back in the game, Ash Barty's back again, and Alex Dimona has joined as well.
We've made sure that obviously all the players look as authentic as possible. We've made sure that the grounds are as, you know, as authentic as we can get them. From the original game, we've really added to the different game modes. We've improved the career mode. We've put much more emphasis on a story element and cinematics, and animations have been improved. The other thing we've done with the animations is add to each of the players' profiles. So there's many more versions of people's serves, their backhands, their topspins, right down to just their mannerisms.
So it took a while to get Kochanov right. And your top of the racket's still top of the racket. The racket spins. And it's almost the reverse of what you think it's going to be.
We've overhauled everything from the gameplay mechanics to the movement. We've introduced a new fabric system to, you know, emulate real cloth physics. It's all about that authentic atmosphere and realism.
Tennis Australia and ourselves collaborate tightly to give fans exactly the realism that is here.
AO2 is our first foray into tennis games on Switch, which means you can play it on the go. It allows everyone to play it wherever they are, whenever they want to, and it has every single feature and function that all the other platforms do.
We've been collaborating now with Big Ant for two versions of the game. We really like the second version and the improvements have made and the progress has been made.
Some of the game modes in AO2 include a online system, career mode, the AO tournament itself, which plays around on all the courts, and also just a casual play where you can just play against your mate.
I really feel that sports fans and tennis fans are going to get the most out of this.
I think the key thing that people enjoy in AO2 is just the added realism we put into the game, and it's just like the Grand Slam itself, it's a lot of fun.
I've always enjoyed personally walking around and putting my friends in the game, changing the venues, all that sort of stuff. But there's nothing quite like walking onto Rod Laver Arena as Rafael Nadal.